الركن الأحمر من الفلبين. In the red corner representing the Philippines, أمين مرسيال.
So here comes the tournament number one seed, the sixth ranked boxer in the world, 24-year-old Martial from the Philippines. His opponent is the 20th ranked boxer in the world, 22-year-old Abilkhan Amankul of Kazakhstan. 2017 World Championship silver medalist preceding the man from the Philippines on that silver medal rostrum at the global event. The judges presiding over this one. There's confirmation of a 4-1 split decision win. A heavy-handed southpaw display from Umir Marcial during the course of that contest. And it was a 3-2 split decision win. The Tang Latian of China, 29th ranked boxer in the world.
Round one.
So we're underway then. Gold medal bout in the 75 kilogram middleweight division. Between the men who have occupied the silver medal rostrum at the two most recent editions of the AIBA World Boxing Championships. The boxer wearing red, operating out of the southpaw stance, is the reigning World Championship silver medalist who is starting quickly to both body and head. And that is Umir Marcial of the Philippines. Ranked number 6 in the world, the tournament number 1 seed, the man wearing blue who is just looking to get himself into the contest after this brisk start. He scores with a good southpaw jab is Abilkhan Amankul from Kazakhstan. He was the silver medalist at the 2017 World Championships in Hamburg. Good double right hand from Marcial. And both of these boxers, well, content to accommodate one another in close quarter boxing. But the busier man is Marcial to begin the round.
Yep, Marcial does like to start fast. This is the one bout tonight that I was particularly excited about, along with the previous bout, but these two are top quality performers, both in the top 10 in the world, and fantastically talented in every area, physically strong, accurate. Oh, beautiful shots there.
Short, hard hooks from both flanks from Amankul.
Amankul is
so tough.
But look
at the response from Martial. And again, the flat-footed posture from both of them as Amankul goes body, then head, then an uppercut through the middle. And after the blistering start in the first half of the round, Amankul said, okay, well, I've seen what you got. This is what I have to bring. What a round so far. My goodness. As much respite as we've had as the two men lock on the inside. Good left cross from Marcial, countered by a right jab from Amankul. Oh, good shot flashed upwards from Amankul. Swiveling the head of Marcial, who was landing his own shots during an exchange. Look at this, toe-to-toe, practically head-to-head as they look for arcing punches at short range.
Marcial would prefer, I feel, from both guys to keep it a little bit longer. He's more effective at long and middle distance with his punches, certainly, as you can see there. But up close, although he is the taller figure, Amankul will prefer when these guys are head-to-head. Look at the stiffness in both men there.
Absolutely incredible action. What a left hand from Martial.
That's where he prefers to punch from, Ron. He likes those heavy, long shots, and then he likes to mix up the hooks as he closes down the distance.
Terrific opening round in the 75-kilogram middleweight gold medal bout.
Well, I always feel we knew what we were going to get here. This man is another one who appears to be enjoying himself. when he's in these kind of head-to-head battles with other world-class operators. Good counter as he moved backwards there, as Martial comes back with a right hook to the body. Yeah, Martial would rather be there rather than here. He likes his straight shots. Good uppercut there, though, from the man in red, as Amankul chops him with a well-timed right hook afterwards.
Seconds out.
Such a confusing operator to compete against as well.
Well, look at that. Amankul. It's a 3-2 split in favour.
Round two.
Of Martial.
I think it was the man in red.
It was.
Who got the three scored, but 10-9. 3-2, very little in this opening round. Action heating up here in this second round. Look at that little smile exchange between the two.
Yep, it wasn't a nicety, believe that.
Martial's face just beginning to graze up. Amankul's visage still comparatively unmarked. Good double jab left cross from the man in blue.
Yep, his facial structure looks like it's been chipped out of marble. Amankul's, doesn't it? Rock hard looking face.
Good shot. Oh, what a right hand to the body, and it doubled over Amankul.
I think it was a little bit low, Ron.
Well, it certainly got a response from this most impassive of figures. It bent him over.
Yeah, he'd be the best poker player out here, wouldn't he? Never changes facial expression.
The crowd of Kazakhstan won once again.
I've noticed as well, when he is hit by one or two decent shots, he looks at you as if he's insulted. Like, how dare you think that you can hurt me? Look at that face. That's why it reminds me of Carl Froch when I say, you know, sometimes you'd nail Carl and he'd just look at you as if to say, you're just going to hurt your hands. I would advise you not to do that.
Good burst of
good defense as well.
But tucking up tightly, that's a good left hand into the body, and then success upstairs for Amankul.
The quality on show here is just unbelievable. From the last bout to this,
contrasting types of cut action, but again, just illustrative as to the amount of variety you can get in this wonderful sport we're witnessing here on the Olympic Channel.
Unbelievable stuff, really. Good body shot there from Amankul.
Every boxer with the same weapons in their armory. Crosses, hooks, uppercuts and body punches, but so much variety. It's like music within those shots that you can select.
Couldn't agree more. Beautiful description of what we get here. The sweet science. They don't call it the sweet science for nothing.
AJ Liebling, the great American writer, coining that phrase in its most appropriate moniker. This most brilliant of sports. We're seeing exponents of it at the highest level here on the Olympic Channel.
Good
right
form.
Uppercut. Right hook to the body, left uppercut to the head from Martial.
Oh, good jab as well.
Jab.
Wow. Amankul. Oh, wow. That stare.
Show of respect at the conclusion.
Think about leaving the ring after being looked at like that.
So the Cuban coach on the perimeter of the ring in the red corner just taking out the mouthpiece of the Filipino boxer. And again, even though it's an individual sport, the share of information.
Yeah.
So many Cuban coaches in different outposts around the world.
Helping out everywhere they go, really, to make boxing a better sport, to pass on their great skills. Both guys just don't get nothing off there. There's a collision. Good right hook from Amankul when he beat him to the punch there. Remember that shot well. But again, I feel it was Martial who maybe just done enough in that round, Ronald.
So it's three judges to two in favour of Martial, but a different distribution of scores. What a contest.
Third and final round.
So a sporting touch of gloves to begin this third round. My goodness, these two men are providing a terrific spectacle. Flat-footed, at center, ring invariably. this one could take place in a lift. Not using the space of the ring at all.
I thought you were going to say a telephone box, the old cliche, but a lift. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
One, good two right hooks from Aman Cole, catching those shots on his glove. Look at the wide-legged stances of the two men practically performing squats.
Yep, trying to get maximum power on their shots, but it's Martial that has the better bust there, Ronald, isn't it?
Arcing right hand over the top.
Both guys having a little bit of a break there.
And look at the eyes of Aman Cole. He was just glancing to his right, waiting for the referee to arrive. It's Martial with the 1-2.
It's the first time I've ever seen him grin or smile. That stone face, normally, eyes are normally fixed with a frightening glare. But not on that occasion.
Well, look at this. Both men just accepting the strength of the other, leaning on the inside. Nobody looking to land rabbit punches or shots around the rear to the liver. Good left hand attempted by Martial, and after that brief respite, they go to work. There's another pause, and the action resumes once again. Aman Cole trying to quicken his feet. Martial up on his toes, missing with the left right, runs into a right jab from the man in blue.
A solid jab as well. And he really sets his foot when he lets that jab go. It's not a light, flicky jab. He really tries to put it home. Shot right uppercut there from our man Cool.
Left uppercut response from Martial.
Yeah, he's answering everything, isn't he? He really is. If you asked me before, and we have spoke about it, I would have fancied our man Cool prior to this bout, Ron.
Martial acquitting himself incredibly well, as is as our man Cool. Our man Cool, there's practically nothing in it. They're taking an increasing amount of time to rest here, because even though they haven't been using their legs to dance around, they've been accommodating the weight of the other. They've been getting down low, practically performing squats, and then exploding up from the feet to land heavy, to let go heavy punches.
Good.
Beautiful
one,
right jab from Martial.
Yep. They'll have sore legs after this. They'll be feeling like the Uzbek coach. They will. They'll have sore everything. Both these boys have been in tremendous bouts throughout this competition, Ronald.
So there's the 10-second clap, but they'll both go for it now in the closing stages. Aman Cole sends him to the canvas. There was a right hand landed to the body. Martial got his feet in a tangle, but not ruled as a knockdown. But the sheer weight of the shot from the man in blue seemed to disrupt the balance of Martial. He thinks he's done enough, so too to his corner. What a contest.
Unbelievable again. We are now getting spoiled here.
I said it was a Cuban coach in the corner, but when I saw a proper look, that's actually one of the old Australian coaches who's made the transfer to the Philippines, so my apologies. And there he is, the man removing the left glove. He used to head up the Australian boxing program, now sharing his knowledge with the Philippines. And that's wonderful to see that respect. Which way is this one going? Likely to be the man in red, given the scorecards after round one and two, but what say the judges? And there's confirmation. Umir Martial, a split decision winner over the man who preceded him as the world championship silver medalist. Wonderful to see that respect. And Umir Martial from the Philippines, the tournament number one seed, prevailing in a terrific gold medal bout over Aman Cole from Kazakhstan. What a fantastic spectacle. A wonderful demonstration of the art of infighting at short and mid-range.
Just fantastic, wasn't it? Brilliant to watch. Like you said as well, Ronald, a little bit different from Zafulin and Abdurayimov. Wasn't as all out action-packed brawl, but the skills and the punch picking on show there were nothing short of tremendous. We just seen two of the best operators on the planet, not in a country or a continent, on the planet at 75 kilos go head to head there for that gold medal again. Another possibility a draw game for me. I feel so bad on the losers in these bouts.
So Martial taking every round for Judge 4, but 29-28 scorecards across the board. Martial edging it. A terrific battle.